energy, 2 CO2 I'm in, and 3 NADH, 1 FADH2 and 1 ATP energy. After glycolysis, 4 ETC happens, cycle of reactions makes ATP energy, 2 CO2 I'm in, and 3 NADH, 1 FADH2 and 1 ATP energy.
I can start back into glycolysis, make 2-3 carbon pyruvates, lose a carbon, mix a acetyl CoA, carbon dioxide, acid breathless waste, cycle regenerates, oxaloacetate, enzyme fusion with CoA, to form citric acid citrate, 6 carbon molecule, 3 carboxyl groups, atoms up, rearrange, now it's acid citrate, oxidation, take a carbon, combining with oxygen, CO2 is produced, releases and releases it, high energy, NAD plus gains, an electron, it becomes NADH, 5 carbon nicotoglutarate, loses CO2, a new NADH is made. Coenzyme A grabbed up.
Bounce the ball.
Now, how many carbons we got?
We got 4.
Succinyl CoA enzyme used. New oxidation energy transform. The synthetase that moves to CoA produces GTP with adduced phosphate. So, GTP and ATP, they're similar, not the same thing. Depending on the cell, you may convert to ATP. Another CoA gone to away. Molecule rearrange, become a succinate. Dehydrogenate, dehydrogenase help produce an FADH move to an FADH2. And now we're looking at the fumarate hydrate, a fumarate enzyme to make malate. It's rearranged dehydrogenase back to this thing, oxaloacetate.
Hey!
That's one full cycle one time. But remember that glucose was split into the next 3 carbon in line. The other pyruvate still got to go on through. In mitochondria, cycle of reactions. Two foods you eat in tub makes ATP energy. 2 CO2 I'm in, and 3 NADH, 1 FADH2 and 1 ATP energy. After glycolysis, 4 ETC happens, cycle of reactions makes ATP energy. 2 CO2 I'm in, and 3 NADH, 1 FADH2 and 1 ATP energy.